Hey guys. Hey Sir Maud. How are things in Canada? What is going on with you guys? Hey Jen. Nice to see some familiar faces. Definitely. All right. Hope you guys are doing well today. Just doing a check-in with everybody. Hi, Sheri. Hi, today we had, how are you? Can you hear me?
Yeah, can you hear me?
I can hear you now. Yeah.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I'm great. You know, doing it.
I'm drinking water. Got my Evian, yep. You got your crystal glass. Hi, everybody. Letting people join. We got a lot of people. We had like 20 people asked to join our video today when I came on. Hi, Eric Vaughn. Lots of people saying hi. It's nice to see some familiar faces. How are you today, Sheri?
I'm doing all right. I'm hanging up on another call. Just so you can see there's a bunch of people there on a call.
Oh, yeah. Hey, everybody.
Yeah.
Work people. We've been on calls all day.
That's right.
I'm doing what I always do when we talk. I'm
eating.
Eating a banana. You got to stay healthy, guys. Hello, Ukraine. All right. So let's get into it. Shall we?
Let's do it. Yeah, definitely.
This is our second live, you guys. Thank you for joining us. This is Sheri Doss at SHERIDOSS. She and I are friends. We are colleagues. We are hairstylists. And we're going to keep coming to you guys. This is our second one. We're going to get to more of what happens next later in our live. But right now, I just wanted to start by doing a check-in with everybody. Sheri's going to share some really important information with you guys. Hey, Dom, how are things in LA? Just want to talk about some real talk at first of how we're doing, and then we want to know how you guys are doing. You know, let us know what's going on with you in your area, in your country, in your city. What are your feelings? We've been taking a lot of questions. We're going to answer some of them later. But for me, I just wanted to, I'll tell you how I've been, and then Sheri's going to tell you how she's been. We kind of just want to do an emotional check-in with you guys.
Yeah.
I think that this is not an easy time for any of us, no matter where you are or what area of the world you're in. We're all at different stages of this, which, for me, Sheri and I both are always traveling. For those of you that don't know, we're always on the go. We're never at home. And we're both social distancing, working from home with our teams and, you know, doing those things. And I had a meltdown with Sheri the other day. I was crying, you know, so if you guys are stressed or having feelings about this, it's totally normal. I'm always a happy person and I'm happy now. I think there's a lot of opportunity and I always try to look at that. But it's been crazy. I wasn't taking a shower the first few days. I wasn't doing my hair. I stopped working out. And for me, it's about normalcy, right? Doing things that make us feel some sense of normalcy. And it took me a minute to change the way I was thinking a little bit. So I've been getting up every morning, making coffee, not Starbucks, making my own coffee here, trying to do things a little differently, take a shower, do my hair. I've been doing push-ups and trying to figure out a little workout routine at the house. Just doing this damn thing. I have to say, I started feeling better when I started giving myself certain schedules and activities right now, going into this, right? What about you, Sheri? I know you did some stories today on your page. What's going on with you?
I did some stories. Thank you for sharing. And yeah. Because Alfredo and I are basically on live calls all day long, I have seen him in his various states of normalcy and not so normal. I'm like, what's going on? What's going on with you today?
Yeah.
And, this morning I got up and did my hair, right? It's actually hairstyle too. I might have to go into a self haircut here, but I started to think about just how I was feeling and what was going on with me. And I see all these comments that are coming in about it being very hard, about, you know, that they're having to close their doors in some cases, that clients aren't coming in some cases. And we know that all of this is what everyone's going through. And so what I was thinking of as I was getting myself ready was, you know, the change curve. And that's what I posted about today, is that there's some of us aren't necessarily feeling great about the place that we're in, or we're judging it, or we hear from other people, we should be this way. Well, we shouldn't be anyway. We should be the way that we're being right now. But coming from a place of loving and honoring that place, right? Not to stay in it, but to, you know, to be strong, if you will, and to, but being strong isn't denying it. And so if you have a chance and can go to my page and go listen quickly to these steps of change, I'm hoping that it's helpful for you just to understand what you're going through. You know, I did say on there, in case you don't get a chance to do that, that I can review them quickly. You've got shock that, wait, what's going on in the world? And I think that, you know, all of us have seen or saw from afar what was happening and couldn't believe that it was happening. But then there was this denial, like, it's not going to happen to me. It's not going to happen in our country. Then getting, as it started to happen, as this virus did, you know, invade our homes, if you will, you know, being angry about it. And then as the government started to tell us what to do, stay home more, etc., you know, being angry about it and sort of bargaining, like, well, I'll do social distancing, but I'm going to hang out with a couple of my friends that I know are okay, and that should be okay. So that bargaining, we can go into a little bit of depression, and depression doesn't always have to be the low of the low. It can be just like a lack of energy or sadness, then a little bit of acceptance. And then there's a few steps after that that I'm not sure any of us are in yet. But, you know, what I was saying, again, if you don't have time, is that it's impacting all of us, right? I am married to a British man who has lost his job here in the U.S. He works for a British company. They're closing down the American office. And the choice was to have him move there, and keep his job, or to stay here and not have one. And right now I seem to be in acceptance, feels like it, because I'm not crying like I was earlier today. And we'll have moments of acceptance where we're looking at apartments together. But then I go into like a little bit of denial, like, oh, maybe you're not going to have to go because the travel ban, or there might be a travel ban. And then anger, bargaining, depression. And what he said to me last night, which I thought was interesting, is that I just face the emotion that's happening. So again, don't judge it. Don't judge it. Like, love yourself anyway, no matter what that emotion is. And keep I call it a detached compassion. And I think that that's just where I'm coming up from, you know, coming from right now. I'm trying to connect with as many people as possible, which is why, you know, I love this. I see everybody's hellos. You don't know what this does to my soul when you send this stuff over. You really keep me in a more accepting and positive place. And I'm hoping that you can do that for each other.
Yeah. And I think, you know, it is about acceptance a little bit and going through the different, I'm where you are today. I think I'm like in a good place. I'm trying to think about gratitude of all, you know, and of what we're going to be doing, helping hairdressers, and what we have coming up and what we've been working on. And, you know, just really having a purpose and feeling that. Hello, Danielle Kiesling. You know, I think for one thing you guys can count on is Sheri and I are going to be here. We're going to be here Tuesdays on my page at 1 p.m. EST. And we're going to be on Sheri's page Thursdays at 1 p.m. EST every week. We're going to check in with you guys. And Sheri and I are already going, wait, let's also come on this day too and check in. So we're probably going to, but you can count on us those two times for sure.
Yeah.
We're going to be checking in with you guys. And, you know, we always want to be on strategy. You know, we want to tell you what we're doing. You can tune in. You can tune out if you want. You can come back. Tell your friends about it. We're going to be giving you guys, you know, a lot of information to go with that. You know, it's basically, we look at this as it's a pre-strategy that a lot of you have already maybe went through. There's a during, which is what a lot of us are experiencing right now. Like Sheri and I working from home. I just moved here to New York, for those of you guys that don't know. So it's a little scary to move here during this time. But I also know I've talked to Sheri about this. I feel that I'm right where I'm supposed to be right now with you guys and with Sheri and you know, us going through this together. But I'm going to let Sheri talk about, you know, and then there's also the post. What do we do when this is over? And a lot of us, I know, are closing our salons. We've been scrolling feeds. We're watching you guys, like you have no idea, looking at everybody's stories and, you know, just every way that we can connect with you guys as possible to just feel the room, if you will, of where everybody's at right now. So I'm going to let Sheri talk a little bit about what we're going to be doing to really address kind of the three stages of what's happening right now throughout the world.
Yeah. Thank you. So there, as Alfredo so rightly put it, there's a pre, during, and post, depending on where you live and what the government and the regulations are asking you to do. And then we break it down into three other areas. So there's pre, during, post, salon, client, and self. And what we want to do is we want to take moments to try and address the questions that you have or the concerns that you have around those things. So as an example, I think pre, we've talked about it. How do we, how sanitation, financial mindfulness. If you are in that pre-phase, remember, start to squirrel some stuff away. Booking clients for health and safety, salon team communication, client, how do you communicate to your client about what's going on? And in some cases that changed really quickly. I know my sister had spent this time really helping her clients understand how she was going to keep them clean, safe, and healthy only for, and they were happy, they were going to come in only for an hour later, her being told that she has to close the doors and she had to address that. So how do you have that conversation? Scheduling pre-coronavirus survival kits. How do we help our clients have what they need to take care of themselves at home? Should this be a situation where they can't come into the salon? For self, health and safety for yourself, mental, emotional preparation. It is a change. And, you know, sometimes if you read that book, Who Moved My Cheese, we're not so good about that move. minimal homes, making sure you have the minimal home supplies. Don't buy all the damn toilet paper, but make sure that you've got enough to keep you and your family safe and comfortable. Check on family members to ensure their health and safety. During, these are, again, topics we're going to dive really, really deep into, okay? And stick with us during, not today, but in the future. During, business tips for lease. So if your doors are closed, what can you do to be a bit proactive? Business tips for lease issues. Like, do you have somebody that you can call? Do you get together with a lawyer that can help you negotiate a 0% lease term or a pause for your lease? Loans, funding, government assistance, marketing, content planning. So now's the time, if you are home, it is that during time for you to start to create content that can market. Salon team communication. Don't stop talking to your salon team. Do this. Get on Zoom. Get on Teams and make sure that you're staying connected with them. If you can still access the salon, can you remodel it, upgrade it? What kind of tools do you need for support? For your client, how to manage their regrowth with root concealer. Like, they're going to need to look good. Lots of people are working from home, so they're going to need, and they're doing it through Teams or through other measures like Zoom, et cetera. And they're gonna need to be seen. And in some cases they have the ability to be a little bit more casual in the way that they look. But in some cases they're gonna need to learn how to just blow dry the front. You know, your clients that have had a blow dry every day or once a week, or they go to the blow dry bar, how do you help them look good for when they have to be visible through their working from home, if you will? How to extend the use of product, how to do a FaceTime consultation for now and for future hair care, how to create a wait list for when the doors are open, very good one. Setting it for yourself, set up structure, mental and emotional management, physical care, how do you stay connected via FaceTime, etc. Level up in areas that you'd like to get stronger. I said this today, I am a shit balayager. Like, I always have that freaking orange right where I feathered up the bleach or the decolorizer. And I'm like, how? How do I not do that? So I usually foliage, so it makes it hot and I don't have to worry about it. But I could use this time to become a better balayager, so that when my doors do open, I can really service my clients in an impactful way. And all of them, design a new healthy regimen. Push-ups. I might need to start doing those, Alfredo.
I'm gonna have to do a video of my in pseudo apartment workout for everybody.
Yeah, I love it. Please, I would do it. You know, how do you copy it out? You know,
yeah, all this
DJ.
Well, everybody, I'm watching all the comments. Yes, you need to DJ Saturday. All these comments are coming in just because I know you're like trying to say everything they're saying
and read it. Yeah, they're
saying this. They're saying this list is amazing. You know, they're saying I'm gonna start taking more education online. Do you guys have ideas about that? I want to up my game. People are saying I'm going to set up a studio, make my first ever hair video on in my house.
Nice.
So just really cool stuff. Yeah.
Nice. You know, the other thing we were saying is, okay, if you're home, you're like, oh, what do? Clean out the closet and shop your closet. Maybe you could go back with a new look or something. Contact politicians. We need that more than ever. Right now in the U.S., there is something you need to sign for the PBA.
Yes.
Please go onto the PBA website. Sign the petition. We need help like other people are getting help. And we really need to do that. Teach your children how to cook or sew. I know that Alfredo would like some child to make him bell bottoms. I said, you know, we can't, you know, we can't have child labor, but if they want to make you bell bottoms, honey, then maybe somebody will make you bell bottoms.
I just want someone to come
DM him for his size.
I just want somebody to come cook for me and just be here for me, because I'm all by myself here, people.
You have to stay in your own apartment.
Social distancing.
We do have some post things coming to you that we will go into more detail. Scheduling, maintaining your wait list, maintaining your sanitation practices, marketing to your clients to get them in, managing your inventory, supplies management, doing team meetings and having your team work together. You know, we are going to have to manage the mistakes that have been made. Again, we've got clients, I've been saying, my mother-in-law has never had her husband see her without her hair and her makeup done. And this is very real. We do have some clients who, you know, are going to end up doing their own hair. Okay. We'd like to teach them how to use. I don't have it out right now. I've got the L'Oreal root spray. That's what I'm doing, but we need to teach them how to do their hair. I'm sorry. while simultaneously, my little nugget is making some noise. While simultaneously, you know, when they come back, if they've done a box dye, we can't shame them, guys. We got to love them. We got to make sure that they understand it's okay and just help them get back to how it looked when we did their hair. We're going to give you some tutorials so that you can either use yourself or share with your friends if you have really long regrowth. How do you make sure that that looks even from roots to ends? And most importantly, yourself. When you go back, we have all of this communication about how people are going to work 12, 15, 16 hours in order to get everybody in. Somebody wants to see my doggy. How we're going to get everybody in. Take breaks. Take care of yourself physically. Where's the beast? Take care of yourself physically. Because it's going to be super important that you do. And also, again, if you created a healthy regimen, then making sure you maintain that healthy regimen. Do you see her? There's the beast. She's not really a beast. She's super tiny. But her name is Hound Dog, Hound Beast, Hound Nugget.
Said, I love the
Hound Preciousness.
Somebody's saying, thinking on the bright side, I think it's going to help encourage guests on rebooking if they normally aren't the type to also. We're also talking about that, too, like getting a wait list together for your clients, keeping in contact with them so that you can get them to pre-book when you know when your doors are going to open again. We're going to be talking about all of this stuff, though.
Yeah. And then, you know, I think right now people are reaching out. You've developed some new communication strategies with your friends, with your families.
Yeah.
And when we go back and we're like in big mode of like fast mode, please maintain those connections with your family and friends. We'll be going, like we said, through all of these, helping helping to help you navigate through this. On Wednesdays, we're going to be asking Ask Me Anything. We'd love for you just to let us know what's on your mind. How can we help you? We do have a lot of questions coming in that we were looking at a little bit earlier, Alfredo, that I thought were pretty important. And we can address some of them now, I think. I think some continue to watch us because there's quite a lot. Should I close being the biggest one? We can't tell you what to do, okay? What we can say is that you do have a local government that is telling you what the right regulations are to make sure that we flatten the curve, okay? I don't want to say what's right for you. I don't know your personal situation, but I do think that following what the health organizations and our local government are saying is the right thing to do, and I think that that's very important. If you are going to keep your doors open, please make sure you do all the things to keep everybody health and safe, barbicide, everything that you can imagine, and with the timing that they have on there as well. You can go on and you can get your barbicide certification, which is helpful. And then communicating to the stylist, we're going to continue to talk to you about that. How do I keep up on my skills? Again, we're gonna make sure that you have all of this. Where do I turn for money? Right now, banks are listening, especially to small businesses. Please take this time to reach out to your banks. It's the most important thing that you do. And again, we're going to keep, I do hope that we get back to some magic with hair very, very soon as well.
We all do.
Send me a video on how I can do some magic with my hair, because I don't know.
Right? I know. People are asking on here if I'm going to keep making hair videos for them to watch. I do have a few stuff that we filmed at a shoot like about a month and a half ago, and I will make some videos, you guys, and put them out along with all this stuff, because we feel like you guys, we know that you still want to be inspired. We know that you guys still want to be getting great education along with all of this information that's so, so needed. And we're going to be doing videos with artists. We've got a lot of really cool stuff coming up that we'll talk about at the end. So make sure you stick around to the end, and we'll tell you some sneak peeks of what's going to be happening in the next few weeks.
Yeah. And I think, I'm getting some good noises coming through my phone. I actually don't know where they're coming from, so I apologize.
They're coming to me really too. Loud. Emails.
Emails. Ooh, emails. So I think, you know, really what we wanted to do today was just to come to you, let you know that we're here for you, let you know when we're going to be here for you. And I see, hi everyone. And just knowing as well that it sounds funny. We'll do whatever you want us to do. But seriously, if you just let us know what it is that you're looking for. I think Alfredo and myself and a few other great hairstylists we've been hanging out with on a regular to talk about, what's going on. We just want to be able to serve you, really. We just want to make sure that you have everything that you need. And we will absolutely direct message us, and we'll make sure that we can help in any way that we can.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're going to be having, you know, like I said, we're going to be here every week, and we're going to start having special guests with us on both my page and Sheri's page on Thursdays. We've already been talking to a lot of our artists out in the industry, industry icons, also people that specialize in things like what Sheri's talking about, you know, business loans. I've been getting emails from companies that I do business with, credit card type things, and they're all offering assistance right now. They're saying, yeah, you know, reach out to us, let us know what you need. So make sure that you're looking at your emails. I know us hairstylists, sometimes we don't read all, make sure you're reading them right now, because there are offers coming in. People are stepping up, companies are stepping up. And that PBA announcement, make sure you go to PBA, because it's so important right now. That initiative right now, that's a United States thing, but in your local government, see what's going on. Because if we all stand up and start signing petitions and let the world know that our hairstylists need assistance, that's how we get shit done. Pardon my
language
for saying shit. But yeah, we're going to be having a lot of artists. We've been talking, Sheri and I both, to people about, they're going to be doing education for you guys. They're going to be having some real talk with you guys. And we're going to be start doing that as soon as next week.
Yes. Yep.
Yeah.
So special guest. So again, we neither Alfredo nor myself are pretending to think that we have all of the answers, but we do have some special guests that will be joining us on how to maintain your schedule, on how to communicate with stylists, with clients. We're going to invite some lawyer friends that we know that can help with negotiation of leases and just answer your questions. So again, keep your questions coming in, knowing that we can't necessarily answer them for just because we don't have the best answer. You know, I like to have experts on that have the best answer, and we'll continue to bring in resources that can bring you those answers. And then starting on April 6th, we are going to be doing live education with various stylists that are experts from all over the world. So we'll give you more information about how to join us for that in a little bit.
I didn't know if we could tell them that. I love that you told them that, because now you told
them everything.
So it's going to be Tuesdays, you guys. Wednesdays, we're going to be doing Ask Me Anything. Make sure you look at Sheri and Maya's page. It's once again at Sheri Doss, Sheridoss. And on my page on Wednesdays, like today, we're answering some of these questions. And then Friday, we'll give you guys a schedule of everything that's going to be happening the following week. But that Monday, starting April 6th, we're going to have guest artists every week. It's going to be, you know, something really exciting that we can't wait to share more with you guys. It's just about ready to be announced. So be on the lookout for that. It's something that you're going to be able to count on every single Monday.
That's right. That's right.
Along with this.
That's right. So,
and let us know, too, right? Let us know what you want to see. Let us know what questions you have, or, you know, like Sheri said, whatever we can do, we're here to serve you, basically. I mean, that is what we're here for. So we want to be there every way that we can.
Awesome. I think I'm going to let's end on one thing that we do at least once a day, Alfredo, when we're having conversations. And, and I think that what, maybe it's helpful for you and something that you can start doing with your salon team. And even at home, I find it very helpful. And that is, something called What I Feel Like Saying. And the intention of it is for a person just to be able to say whatever is on their mind for, you know, with no judgment, no interacting, no asking questions, just whatever it is that they want to say, so that it allows them to have more of an open space moving forward. When they're done, they say, and that's what I feel like saying. And then we say, thank you, name of the person. And then that person asks the next person. So if it's, you know, mom, dad, brother and sister, it'd be like, mom, what do you feel like saying? Mom would say it. She'd say, and that's what I feel like saying. And they'd say, thanks, mom. And then she'd say, okay, son, what do you feel like saying? And so on. So we're just going to show you what that looks like right now. So Alfredo,
and I'm going to start, like, just saying, so you guys know, the way it works is Sheri will always go last, because Sheri says amazing, amazing stuff at the end. You'll know why. You're like, no pressure. But she does.
What do you feel like saying, Alfredo?
What I feel like saying is, you know, it was really great to do this live right now, and I'm actually feeling grateful that we're going to be doing this together and being able to help our community. It was great to see familiar people that we work with and know from the industry, from all different brands and places, coming on right now and saying hi and giving great commentary, and also seeing hairstylists that I see on Instagram just from connecting with us and seeing them on pages, and just seeing them get us so involved, and just seeing all the different comments and concerns and just the community. I feel I am in a good place. It's been an up and down thing, I'm not going to lie, and it's going to be like that. So this, you guys and Sheri, I feel happy and grateful right now, which is a nice way to feel sometimes in the current climate.
Excellent.
Yeah, Sheri, that's what I feel like saying. Sheri, what do you feel like saying?
Thank you, Alfredo. I feel like saying I share your sentiments exactly, and many of the sentiments of everyone who is writing into us right now, letting us know how they feel, saying hello, being a part of it, connecting, and just being who we are. We are hairstylists. We are hairstylists that want nothing more than to make the world beautiful, and that happens with our magic hands doing magic hair. It also happens with the words that we say, the ear that we have when we're listening to clients, and the heart of which we approach every single thing that we do. And so now, more than ever, so long as we can continue to do those things with our clients, even though they're not in our chairs in some cases, and with each other, we will uplift the collective consciousness, and we will make it a place where we know that we are supporting one another and can get through this. And I know we will get through this, and I'm grateful for each and every one of you. And that's what I feel like saying.
Thank you so much, Sheri. And now you see why Sheri goes last. That was amazing. Thank you, Sheri, so much. I love you. And I miss you. I miss seeing you in person, but it's great to see you on here.
I miss you too.
Thank you, everyone. We are going to start uploading these onto IGTV in different formats in case you missed part of it. It's going to be up here for 24 hours, but just so you know, we have a plan, and we're going to start just giving you guys, 360 all the time. We're coming for you. So thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you, everyone. Bye, love Sheri. You.
Bye. Love you.
Bye.
Bye.